So by putting the moment, so what we do is you take the CG location and CP as variables. That means the center of gravity is not fixed. By ballasting you can change it. So first you assume at some place, no ballast, and assume the CP location to be equal to diameter for x and z. Then what you do is, in this calculation you will see that you have these forces L and D, which will be half rho v square. Similarly M will also have half rho v square L. So there is a v there, which is the velocity. So what you can do is vary the velocity from 0 to v max, which is expected, and calculate the alpha at which it trims. Okay. For every velocity there will be a different alpha at which it trims. So I will show you in the next slide, it is possible for you to invert the relationship in such a way that you get d, you can take a derivative of cm by du, dou cm by dou u equal to 0. That means whatever be the velocity, my alpha remains the same because my cm remains the same, it is possible. So to answer this question in detail, there is a very interesting paper written by a BTech student called Ashok Rajani. Interestingly, last week he got married and I got a card from him. So Ashok Rajani did his BTech here in 2008 and 9, I think, and with Professor Sudhakar as the co-author, we did some work on the dynamic stability analysis of a tethered aerostat system, and it appeared in Journal of Aircraft. So it's a big achievement for a BTech student to publish a paper in Journal of Aircraft. So I'm very proud of this guy. So you can see what he has done. You will see many things which are already discussed with you. So he has done a very good work on the historical developments in modeling and simulation of aerostats. A very nice piece of work where all papers were reviewed very nicely. Then he looked at the ADRD aerostat. And he did the equilibrium analysis, but this analysis was done based on the method given by Professor Krishnamurthy and Panda. Now Krishnamurthy and Panda, this paper has come from NAL Bangalore. Professor Krishnamurthy was a professor of aerospace engineering at IIT Kanpur, and then towards the end of his career he shifted to Bangalore to NAL, and there he supervised some scientists called Panda to work on the, to derive the expressions which I just told you. So Krishnamurthy and Panda's report is a very famous report, which gives basically the picture which I showed you, then it gives equations for the forces, the moment equation and the force equation, and finally if I just save some time, in the end you will see there is a very interesting chart which he gives. Okay, so I will upload this paper and you can read it and derive the expressions and use them. So this is the picture from that particular paper, which is very similar to what we saw, but there are some minor changes. Now the locations B, G, etc. are all variable, don't worry about them. You, by looking at the value of xj and xc, you can always change the location. Okay. So the forces are weight, buoyancy and aerodynamic forces. These forces can be converted into x force, y force and a moment and the tension. So if you take the balance of the forces along the x direction, you will see that Fax will be equal to this force La, and this will be alpha. So the vertical force, horizontal force will be basically L Cl sin alpha and Cd cos alpha, and if you take the vertical force will be Cl cos alpha plus Cd sin alpha times half rho v square. A is the volume power 2 by 3 here. Okay. And moment, as I already showed you, is half rho v square A into L into Cm naught. And then he defines the differences as Cx and Cz, which are the locations. So coming back to the same equation, let us do this derivation ourselves. I think it is important for us to get the feeling. So, can you look at the figure and help me in force balance in the xz plane? So, can you get this expression please? Now, do not copy it down blindly. Do the force balance. So, on your notebooks, I want you to carry out the force balance. There you go. Are you able to see? Okay. Now you can see. So, take the balance of forces along the x axis or along the center line of the envelope. So, remember the forces that you will consider will be B, BF or the buoyancy force. It will have two components, BF sin theta and BF cos theta. Similarly, you have W, W cos alpha, W sin alpha. Then you have L, again sin alpha and cos alpha, and then you have D, sin alpha and cos alpha, and then you have this TV and TH, which are the vertical components of the tension and horizontal component. This is also at an angle theta. So, along x for example, you will have TH cos theta acting along the right side, which is the positive side. And you will have TV sin theta acting in the opposite direction. Similarly, you will have LA cos, LA sin theta acting on the left direction, BF sin theta acting this way, and W sin alpha, but D cos theta will be along the direction. So, please take these moments and get the expression. Similarly, do it for the vertical components. In the vertical components, remember the downward force is positive, okay. Upward is negative, downward is positive, because from center line down is the positive axis. So, you will have negative component of BF, BF cos theta, negative of LA cos theta, you will have positive of DA sin theta, positive of W cos alpha. You will have negative of TH sin theta, sorry, positive of TH sin theta and negative of TV cos theta. So, with this, please get me the expressions for the two forces. The moments are to be taken along the x direction and normal to it. So, along the x direction, you will have FAX. And vertical will be FAZ. Those of you who have finished, you must start the moment balance now. So, for the moment balance, there are these distances XA, XG, XB, and for the tether, we have XC and ZC. The moments are to be taken about the confluence point, for which you will need the distance between the confluence point and B, constraint points, and G, confluence point, and A. So, for that what they have done is, they have given you a term called as, for example, you have a term XG minus XC, which is CX. Similarly, for the gravity, you have ZG minus ZC, yeah, that is XC and ZC. From the nose, the location is X and Z for the confluence point. So, it is XC below and ZC ahead. Here you do not see to be ahead, but the distance is, so ZC will be, draw a vertical line from here up to here, and the difference between that and the nose will be ZC. Ready? You have done it? Let me show it to you. So, these are the two force equations you will get. You can see them in the figure now. Fax is the force minus Bf sin alpha, it will go on that side to become positive. So please notice that Fax is the net force which will be made equal to 0. So you take all the terms other than Fx on that side, you will get the correct signs. For example, W cos theta is shown negative here because it is brought on this side. Fax and Faz are actually lift and drag. These are basically the aerodynamic forces acting, which are being equated to other forces for equilibrium. So Fax is actually your L, your D, and Faz is basically L only. Yes. Fax. It's an angle. Okay. So, if you see what we are doing is now we are basically, so basically you know along this direction you have Fax. Actually, this direction is Faz. This direction is Fax. Along the line and normal to the line. Okay, now let us balance the moment about the center of confluence point. So balance the moments about CP. Okay, I will just go ahead because you will be able to get these numbers only and only if you do the calculations. Okay, from this point we will do a small hand calculation. So you will have the notes with you, so you can derive it yourself. Important point is I have copied the equation from the previous slide here to give you the moment balance, and then I always bring in the fact that Fax is this, Faz is this, Ma is this, Cl is basically lift curve slope AB into sin alpha, and CD is V naught plus KCl square, but Cl and alpha are related by alpha Cl curve, so it could be equal to alpha square. So this K is not 1 by pi AE, this K is a constant which gives you the link between CD and alpha square. Understand that Cl versus alpha is a straight line. So for every alpha there is a corresponding Cl. So when I have KCl square, I can have K dash alpha square, where K dash takes care of K and the relationship between dCl by d alpha. So if you put all these expressions, for example, if you replace Faz with this expression, okay, I have done this myself, you get the expression given in my paper. So right now at the moment, those of you who are interested to verify, go home comfortably, paper is already going to be uploaded, look at the equations, see what happens now. Now let us see how we use this expression to get the value of the optimal location. Now if you look at this expression, Cm is the net moment coefficient which should be 0 at equilibrium. Cm naught is the aerodynamic moment of the body, which is a fixed number based on the geometry of the body. It is available to you from aerodynamic data. Av is the lift curve slope, which is fixed and available. Then you have CD, drag coefficient, which is known from aerodynamics. Xa bar, Xg bar, Xcx bar are basically Xa upon L, Xg upon L. The momentum will have an L term, when you divide it, it becomes bar. This is all geometry, it is known to you. So the only variable in this are u, that is the velocity, and alpha. So what you can do is you can solve this expression Cm equal to 0 for various velocities, you will get various alphas. But if you take a differentiation of this with u, dou Cm by dou u, then you get an, and if you say that is equal to 0, that will give you an expression which is invariant with velocity. So then at every velocity you will have the same value of alpha, which is the equilibrium or trim alpha, and that is a good thing for you because you do not care what velocity Aristotle is flying, you do not want Aristotle to keep changing the alpha with time. So, the same expression I have copied here, and I want to show you the variation of the equilibrium angle of attack alpha with velocity for two conditions. One is the constant CD condition. That means in this expression you assume CD to be constant, basically K is 0. So therefore there is no change with alpha, so you get this. So what you see is at 0 velocities or low velocities the aerostat will trim at a high angle, and as the velocity increases this angle will keep reducing, and a time will come when there will be hardly any change. So at around 10-12 meter per second onwards the angle is not changing much, so the aerostat will trim at this angle at low speeds and then come, and then it will become almost fixed. Now this particular information has come from this Krishnamurthy and Panda's report. I will just show you, I have scanned this report because it is an old report from NAL, and in this they have done the analysis. This particular work was sponsored by ADRD Agra. So in the end they have actually done the analysis for one ADRD aerostat, and they have given the pictures which I showed you. These two figures are from the same report only.